Hello and good day to all of you. So in this video lecture, we are going to discuss about two different type of days. One of them is sidereal day and another is a solar day. So before starting the lecture, we have some learning outcome. So the first learning outcome of this lecture is to learn and understand the Earth's sidereal and the solar days. And the second objective of this lecture is to get an understanding how the length of these days are calculated. So with relate to some other factors we are going to discuss in detail. So let's look at what is actually the sidereal versus solar day. So when we are talking about the sidereal day, is a time takes for Earth to rotate about its axis so that the distant star, which is not the sun, appears in the same position in the sky. So let's say today you are looking at the sky and you observe one star at the sky. So exactly after 24 hours or maybe so, how much time it will take? Let's say it takes 24 hours. Obviously it will not take 24 hours, less than that, to become that star at the same position. So normally the sidereal day is about 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds. And obviously you know the solar day, which is a day which takes time the Earth to rotate around its axis and at the time the sun appears at the same position. So normally the solar day, which you very well know, it's actually 24 hours. And although it can be very much plus minus 25 seconds, which is we are going to discuss further. So keep in mind, so the first sidereal day is actually 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds, and the solar day is 24 hours. So now we look at how it can be explained further. So let's say this is your sun, which we have in yellow color, and you are standing over here, which is the red dot. So let's say you are calculating a solar day on the observation of this Earth. So if you're standing here and then after 12 hours you will be here because the Earth is rotating, then after 24 hours exactly you will be going, you're going to be here again because the sun, the Earth is spinning. So you can observe the same position because where you was observing here and on the green point, and now you are here at the red point. So this will add actually one extra degree of the rotation which need to get back the sun overhead. So it's talking about the overhead. So you can imagine, because it's actually need 360 degree, but obviously the earth is also rotating, so that's why it will add one extra degree to the angle of the solar day. So now we look at the sidereal day. So this is, let's say, is our Earth, and this is Sun, and this is the position just now and after 24 hours. So which one we have explained previously. So if you look at the other star, which is the distant star here, and this angle is increased because of the more distance. So let's say today or right now you are here, and after exactly 24 hours or 23 hours 56 minutes you will be here. So the same star you are looking from this position will be again referring to this position is exactly after 23 hours 56 minutes and 4 seconds. So that is actually the sidereal day. So now we look at how or why the sidereal day is 4 minutes shorter than the solar day. So let's look at the solar day, which is actually 361 degree rotation, which takes actually 24 hours as I mentioned in the previous figure. So the sidereal day is actually 360 degree rotation because in this one this is so far, so that's why there is no need of adding 1 degree because it's quite far away, so the angle can be ignored. So, but the sidereal days actually take 360 degree rotation. So now we can calculate the length of the sidereal day, which is 360 divided by 361 into length of the solar day. So length of the solar day is 24 hours, which is equal to 23.95. If we convert these hours into minutes and seconds, so you can get the exactly this is the minutes which we get from this observation. So the sidereal day length is actually 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 minutes less than the solar day. So that is the calculation of the sidereal day, how we calculate it. So now we look at the rotation speed difference. So recently, it's not recently, but in last decades, 1999 to 2005, the average annual length of the mean solar day in excess of 86,400 SI second has varied between 0.3 millisecond and 1 millisecond, which must add it to both the stellar day or the sidereal day or the solar day, which means it's actually the negligible, but still you have to be account 0.3 millisecond or 1 millisecond and 1 millisecond in the 0.3 millisecond is for stellar day and this is for the sidereal day. So the equatorial radius of the Earth in the world geodetic system, which is WGS 84, ellipsoid is actually this amount, 6 million something meter, which multiply the Earth equatorial radius by its angular velocity yield Earth rotation speed at the equator is actually 465.1 meter per second and also 1674.4 kilometer per hour. So either it's meter per second or kilometer per hour. So you can have this speed at the equator of equatorial rotation of the Earth. So with that's all. I hope you have understand the solar day and sidereal day and also how we can calculate the solar and sidereal day. With that's all. Thank you so much and have a good day.